Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with Manipur violence. Now this is a very important topic. This is an important topic from general studies mains examination paper 2 point of view, plus this is also important for political science, for sociology and for public administration, and also for anthropology optional students. Now in order to understand this entire violence process, we need to understand the three contours, the three important aspects about this topic. Now the first contour being the contour of the existing communities, the different type of communities existing in Manipur, because this is essentially a conflict between the communities. The first being Metai community, then it is Kuki community, and then we have got the Naga community. So this is the first contour that we really need to understand in order to understand this Manipur violence. The second contour being the BJP versus Congress, and the third contour being very important thing that we need to understand is the concept of gerrymandering. Gerrymandering, this is a very important concept to be understood in order to get a complete understanding, holistic understanding about Manipur violence. Now let us understand about the different communities existing in Manipur. Broadly, three communities exist, inhabit this Manipur landscape. The number one is Metai. Now this Metai community is actually a Hindu community. It is a Hindu community. And the Kuki community, though it was a tribal community, but this community has developed. And this is the reason that this Kuki community shares a lot with this Metai community. Means their culture, their material aspect of the life of this Kuki community, the structural aspect and the non-structural aspect, it similarizes with that of Metai community. And then we have got the Naga community. Now this is the community that is basically tribal. This is the community that is less educated relatively to the Metais. This is a community that is less aware. This is a community that don't reside in the plain regions of Manipur. This is the community that fears, that feels the fear of being persecuted by the Metai community. This is the community that feels the dominance, the hegemony, the ascendancy of the Metai community. This is the community that feels neglected. This is the community that feels that they are being exploited. This is the community that feels a lot of disenchantment from the current setup. This is the community that generally fights with the Metai and the Kuki community. This is the community that have a kind of antagonistic relationship with the Metai community. Now the reason why. Why this disenchantment? Why this attrition? Why this conflict? Understanding this why, we need to understand the politics of this region, of this Manipur. In order to understand this, we need to understand the current government that is ruling in Manipur. Presently, Manipur is being ruled by the Congress government. The Congress has been ruling Manipur since 2002. So quite a long period, about 14 years. And next year in 2017, the elections would be taking place in Manipur. Now the BJP is extending its mandate quite fastly. It's extending its realm quite quickly in Manipur. And it is trying to influence this Metai community, and this Metai community is basically this Hindu community. And in order to arrest, in order to restrict, in order to contain the influence of the rising BJP, the Congress government has resorted to a political measure. What is that political measure? The political measure is to divide the Manipur, is to bifurcate certain districts, and to institutionalize, and in order to implement this gerrymandering. Now, what is this gerrymandering? Gerrymandering is a process of dividing constituencies in such a manner so that a community may not be able to exercise its collective power. Now, the important thing to understand is what is collective power of a community. Now, if a community is more in number, if a community is majority in number in a particular constituency, they will be able to protect their rights in a better manner because they will be voting collectively. Now, if you tend to create such constituencies in which no particular community has a majority, in that case, you are actually resorting to gerrymandering. This is what is called as gerrymandering. Now, before December 9, Manipur was having just 9 districts. Now, out of 9 districts, 7 districts, they have been bifurcated. It means 7 plus 7 districts have been created, 14 districts plus 2. So, Manipur, which was earlier having just 9 districts, it has been converted into a state which now has 16 districts. And this bifurcation has been done in such a manner so that this Naga community may not be able to exercise its power. It has been done in such a way so that the grievances of the Meitei community can be placated. It has been done in such a way so that the BJP may not be able to extend its influence. It has been done in such a way so that the political calculations may allow the Congress to win again. So it is actually like playing two communities against each other. And this is the reason why Nagas, they are against the creation of this new districts, because in the new districts, they are not in the majority. Now, if they are not in the majority, they won't be able to exercise their power in democracy. In democracy, you can exercise your power only if you have got the collectiveness, if you've got majority, if you've got collective voice. If your voice will be partitioned, you will not be able to exercise your voice. Your voice cannot be heard in democracy. In democracy, you can make your voice heard only if you have collectiveness, if you have the substance in it. And this is how the voice has been divided. This is one issue. In order to understand this entire Manipur issue in a holistic perspective, we also need to understand the concept of inner line permit. Now, this, what is inner line permit? Inner line permit is a kind of a permit that is offered to the outsiders to just come, stay, enjoy, and go back. This permit doesn't allow you to buy land. This permit doesn't allow you to settle. This permit doesn't allow you to carry out occupations. This permit doesn't allow you to exploit the land in the plain regions of Manipur. Now the Nagas, they feel that this inner line permit was the issue last year. And in order to placate these Meitais, the government has come out with this inner line permit. And government had introduced 3 bills. Manipur Protection of People Bill, Manipur Shop and Establishment Bill, Manipur Land Reforms Bill. Now all these 3 bills has been rejected by the president. And this was one of the reasons that in the past, Congress government failed to address the concerns of the Meitei community. And this is the reason why now they have created these more districts in Manipur. So this was all about the issue. You can definitely get a question on this Manipur violence in next year mains examination. This is a very important topic. And in order to read more on it, You can just read the notes that we have uploaded on biraniias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.